بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The title of today's lecture, inshallah ta'ala, is the characteristic of tolerance in the month of Ramadan. We know as Muslims, walillahi ta'ala alhamd, that we're not ibad Ramadan. We're not servants or slaves of Ramadan, but rather as Muslims, those who submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are ibadur Rahman, the slaves of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ibadur Rahman, and the servants or the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have certain attributes and they have certain characteristics. And these attributes and these characteristics of ibadur Rahman, they're not only in the month of Ramadan, but at every single month of the year, 12 months of the year, 365 days of the year, 24 hours a day, and every minute of the hour. However, the reason the title of the lecture of is tolerance in the month of Ramadan is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا, that indeed in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for you is a perfect example. When it came to acts of ibadah, acts of worship, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will make effort in Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, he will not make in any other month. And when it came to Ashr al-Awakhir, when it came to the last 10 days of Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will make efforts in those last 10 days, he doesn't do during any other time. Likewise, we know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is of the best of characters. So exemplary is the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to prove the excellence of his character, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْقَلَمِ وَمَا يَسْتُرُونَ, that I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I swear by the pen and that which they inscribe, that which they inscribe. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by his ni'mah, مَا أَنْتَ بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ بِمَجْنُونَ وَإِنَّ لَكَ لَأَجْرًا غَيْرَ مَمْنُونَ, and for you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a reward which you never ever seize. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, and you have the highest moral character. The character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Ramadan, outside Ramadan, was the highest character. But in Ramadan, those characteristics, those characters of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of Ramadan was even greater. And what is the proof of this? From the characteristics of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is that it was said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ما سُئِلَ شَيْءٌ قَدْ فَقَالَ لَا, nobody will ever ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for anything, he will say no. He always said yes. That he sallallahu alaihi wasallam كَانَ أَجْوَدُ النَّاسِ, he was the most generous of the people. However, أَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونُ, the most generous he will be في رمضان, it will be the most generous in the month of Ramadan. It will be like ruih al-mursala, a gentle wind, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the month of Ramadan. So the month of Ramadan, although we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the whole year, we should have good characters through the whole year, we should increase in these good characters, especially during the month of Ramadan. During the month of Ramadan, this blessed month of Ramadan. So why is it important to have specifically tolerance, pardoning, forgiving, overlooking, especially in the month of Ramadan? Why is the sifa, the attribute of tolerance, more important in Ramadan than any other time? Last week in the fiqh of Ramadan, we spoke about al-illa, the reason why we fast in Ramadan. And he said, do we fast in Ramadan so we become fitter, is healthier? Do we fast in the month of Ramadan so we could feel the pain and the suffering, the thirst, the hunger other people are going through? Is this why we fast in Ramadan? Is this the reason behind fasting? Are these the reason behind fasting? No. The reason why we fast in the month of Ramadan is as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you may increase in what? At-taqwa, piety, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first reason we need to have this attribute of al-afu, of pardoning, tolerance, forbearing, overlooking and forgiveness in the month of Ramadan, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He describes the muttaqeen, those who have taqwa, which is something we're supposed to attain in the month of Ramadan, what is their attributes? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Race, compete with each other. For what? For forgiveness from your Lord. And a Jannah, a paradise which with is like that of the heavens and the earth. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That is prepared for the muttaqeen. Those who have taqwa, who have attained taqwa, some of us are supposed to achieve in this month of Ramadan. And what are the attributes of the muttaqoon? What are the attributes? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these are the ones yunfiquna fi ad-darra'i was-sarra'. They spend from their money in times of ease or in times of hardship and in times of ease. And what are the other attributes? Wal-kadhimin al-ghayb. They are the people that they hold their temper, they control their temper, and they control their anger. Which is something we're supposed to achieve in this month of Ramadan. Controlling our nafs and our temper. To the point the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا كَانَ صَوْمُ يَوْمُ صَوْمُ أَحَدِكُمْ. If one of you is fasting, and somebody سَبَّهُ وَسَإِنْسَوْتِ him أَوْ شَاتَمَهُ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي امْرُؤٌ صَائِمٌ. Just say, I am fasting. To show you should control your temper in this month of Ramadan. So the attributes of the muttaqoon is to spend. The attributes of the muttaqoon is to control your temper. But does it stop there? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. One of the attributes of the muttaqoon, they're people عَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. They pardon people, they're tolerant. So this attribute of a taqwa, one of the things that leads to it is الْعَفُ عَنِ النَّاسِ, to pardon the people. So the first step is what? To hold your temper. The second status, a higher level, is what? عَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Those who pardon people. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves the doer of good. And this is the highest level. Level of ihsan. That somebody offends you, you hold your temper. Understanding. لَيْشَ شَدِيدٌ بِسُرَعَ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. The one that is strong is not the one that's quick to wrestle you to the ground when he's angry. وَلَكِنَّ الشَّدِيدُ مَنْ يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ. But a strong person that can control his temper. This is the first level. But some people go a higher level above this. And that level is what? عَافِينَ. They pardon you on top of it. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And then there's a third level, which is a level of ihsan. He doesn't only hold his temper. He doesn't only pardon you. But you offend him and he does something good for you. He actually gives you a present due to your offense of him. So this month of Ramadan is a month we should increase in this forbearance and tolerance. Because these are sifat, these are the attributes of the muttaqun. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَن تَعْفُوا, pardon each other. Why? هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Pardoning is closer to taqwa, to fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This month of Ramadan should be a month of forbearance, tolerance, and forgiving and pardoning more than any other month. Why? This month of Ramadan, as we mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will make efforts, especially during Ashr al-Awakhir min Ramadan, during the last 10 days of Ramadan. Why would he make these efforts during the last 10 days of Ramadan? يَلْتَمِسُ مَاذَا لَيْلَةَ الْقَدَرِ. Seeking out لَيْلَةُ الْقَدَرِ. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. What will make you know or convey to you what لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ is? وَحُكْمُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ فَرْعٌ مِنْ تَصَوُّرِهِ. And a ruling of something is only a branch of it. So we have to define, to show the importance, this is لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ and its connection to tolerance. What is لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ? Because the brothers, mashallah ta'ala, may Allah reward you doing i'tikaf, the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ is to do so, seeking out what? Laylatul Qadr. That in these last 10 days, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shadda mi'zarahu. He will tighten his lower garments, meaning he will stay away from his wife, or ijtihad, make efforts in ibadah. Wa ahya laylahu, he will stay up the whole night. Wa ayqadha ahlahu, and he will wake up his family. We're all doing this seeking laylatul qadr. Who could tell me the meaning of laylatul qadr? I'll do 50% of it for you. Layla is night. So the night of? What does qadr mean by itself? So the night of Qadr, what does Qadr itself mean? Naam. The night of? Naam. This is one of the meanings of Qadr. That the night of decree. And what is the proof of this? The saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Dukhan. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set down this Quran fi laylatin mubarakah. He set this Quran down on a blessed night. Fiha yufraku kullu amrin hakeem. It's on this night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees everything. So Laylatul Qadr, the night of Qadr decree. But this is not the only meaning. Because the Arabs, if something is of greatness to them, they'll give that thing either more than one name or more than one meaning. So the Arabs, for example, the honey, they have more than 80 names for the word honey. Sword, more than 200 names for the word sword. Lion, so many names for the word lion. Laith, Asad, Hamza. So Laylatul Qadr has more than one meaning. Who could give me another meaning of Laylatul Qadr? Laylatul Qadr, in Arabic, Al-Qadr, it means something of great value, something of significance. So if you say, Hadha Rajul Dhu Qadr, this man is a man of Qadr, of value, estimation, and significance. And what is the proof of this? The saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدِرِهِ. They've not given Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his true value and his true measures. So Laylatul Qadr means the night of what? Significance. Laylatul Qadr, what's another meaning of Qadr? Al-Qadr, from the meaning of Qadr, is power. Yeah? Another meaning of Qadr is something which is tight or constraint. Very, very, very tight. And what is the proof in the Quran that Qadr means something which is tight and constrained, deep? What's the proof in the Quran? The saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانِ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقًا. That as for mankind, when Allah ta'ala tests him, قَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ, he causes his provision to become what? Constrained and tight. So why is Laylatul Qadr? Why is it called a night of tightness, the night of deep? Why is it called a night of tightness? The reason it's called a night of tightness because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said tanazzalu, that the angels doing Laylatul Qadr, more tanzilu, not they're going to descend, tanazzalu, yadullu ala al-istimrar, that the angels doing Laylatul Qadr, they will descend and descend and descend continuously ila al-fajr. To the point that say it's called Laylatul Qadr, the night of tightness due to the large volumes or amount of angels upon the face of the earth. Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha radiallahu anha, now we know what Laylatul Qadr is. She said, in wufiqtu, if I was to be blessed or granted the opportunity of Laylatul Qadr, what dua should I make? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what dua did he teach her? Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you're the one that loved to pardon. You love to pardon, you're the pardoner and you love to pardon, so pardon me. So this is the most important dua you can make when? Laylatul Qadr. If you're to be guided to Laylatul Qadr. This dua. But from the things that cause our dua to be accepted before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us or to give us something. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا إِحْسَانِ. Is the reward for goodness anything but goodness? كَمَ تَدِينَ تُدَامْ. As you do, you should be rewarded. So if you want good, you do good. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, Allah, أَذْكُرْكُمْ. I remember you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرْكُمْ. If you aid Allah's cause, Allah will aid you. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي. Be true to your covenant with me. أُوفِي بِعَهْدِكُمْ. I'll be true to you. So if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon you, what should you do? If you want Allah to pardon you, pardon others. Pardon others. This is a great significance. The more you pardon people, the likelihood is you prepared by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَحُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So if you want Allah to pardon you, during this month of Ramadan, we should also have the attributes of Al-Afu, pardoning people. Pardoning people in this month of Ramadan. So these are the connection of Al-Afu, of pardoning or tolerance with the month, or connected to the month of Ramadan. And as we said, the issue or the attributes of forbearance and tolerance is something we should have throughout the whole year. And if we look at the Salaf, our forefathers from the Sahaba, those who came after them, they're extremely tolerant. One of the Salaf, Maymun ibn Mahran, had a slave girl, a maid. And she was bringing some food to him. And as she was bringing the food, she had hot stew or soup. And she tripped and she spilled it all over him. And when she spilled it on him, Maymun, rahimallahu ta'ala, he wanted to hit her. So this slave girl, you know what she said to Maymun? She said, Ya Mawlaya, ista'mil qawla Allah ta'ala. Oh my sir, oh my master, oh my owner, implement the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal kadhimin al ghayb. Those who hold their temper, those who control their anger. This slave girl, the maid, she said this to him. When she said this to him, he said, قَدْ فَعَلْتُ. I've done it already. To show how the Salaf, they submit to the book of Allah Ta'ala and the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. فِي الْحَالِ. As soon as he heard the saying of Allah Azza wa Jal, حَاضِر. I've done it. But this slave girl, she increased and said to him, that اعمال بما بعده. It's not enough, she said. Do what is after it. والعافين عن الناس. Those who pardon the people. So he said to her, قد عفوت. I've pardoned you. Then the slave girl said to him, اعمال بما بعده. It's still not enough. Do what comes after that. The third level. والله يحب المحسنين. Allah loves those who do good. So Maymun, he said to her, أَحْسَنْتُ إِلَيْكِ. I'm showing goodness to you. فَأَنْتِ حُرَّ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. I free you for the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Salaf, رحمهم الله تعالى, they used to leave their house. One of them would leave his house. And upon leaving his house, he said, Allahumma, O Allah, قَدْ أَحْلَلْتُ عِرْضِي مِنْ كُلِّ عَبْدٍ. O Allah, I have made my honor, my dignity, halal for every single servant, every single slave of yours. Meaning whoever insults me, whoever abuses me, whoever fights me, I've made it halal. For your sake, O Allah. This is how the Salaf used to go out. So this month of Ramadan should be that month of tolerance. That whatever anyone says to you, they do to you, you have the attribute of tolerance to continue after Ramadan. And you find sometimes, in Ramadan, people's temper actually increases sometimes. And your temper in Ramadan is supposed to be calmer. And you're like, Akhi, why are you so angry? Inni sa'im. I am fasting. No, inni sa'im, you should even be calmer and not even be more angrier. You should be calmer during the month of Ramadan. So that this attribute, if we still have it, will be like from the Salaf. That they made the ird, the honor, available for everybody without losing their temper. And be forbearing. That if somebody insults you in this month of Ramadan, be like that individual that the Sha'ir spoke about. That يُخَاطِبُنُ سَفِيهٌ بِكُلِّ قُبْحٍ وَأَقْرَهُ أَنْ أَكُونَ لَهُ مُجِيبًا. That the foolish one, it directs all forms of insults towards me. But I dislike and I hate to answer him. I dislike and I hate to answer him. He said, my example is like the example of Ud. You know Ud or Bukhur? Yeah? يَزِيدُ سَفَاهَةً وَأَزِيدُ حِلْمًا. The more it increases in his stupidity, his ignorance, the more I increase حِلْمًا, intolerance and perseverance. كَعُودٍ زَادَهُ الْإِحْرَاقِ tayyiban. My example is like the example of the oud or the bukhur or the incense. The more heat you apply to it, what happens? The better the smell that comes out of it. We should be like this in Ramadan or ba'da Ramadan. The Salaf, rahimahullah ta'ala, likewise, one of them, Qais, rahimahullah azza wa jalla ibn Asim, once his nephew was killed, and they brought forth the killer of his nephew. And when they brought forth the killer of his nephew, the young man that killed his nephew, he turned to him and he said to him, Ya Bunay, oh my son, subhanAllah, this is somebody that's killed your nephew. He said to him, Ya Bunay, my son, bitsa ma sana'at, indeed wretched and evil is that which you've done. Naqasta adla, your character or your trustworthiness has become deficient or decreased. And likewise, you've brought shame upon your people. And likewise, you've made your enemy happy with what you've done. So after giving him all this lecture, because when you kill, you are killed, life for a life. And nafs bin nafs, he said to them, خَلِّوا سَبِيلَهُ, let him go for free. Leave him. And he said to them, take to the mother of the one who's been killed, dear, blood money. And the killer left, just like that, and forgave him. But the amazing thing is, they said his face, even during this moment of speaking to him, he didn't change. Nor any sign of anger upon him. Subhanallah. And Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah ta'ala, used to say, كُلُّ مَنْ ذَكَرَنِي فَفِي حِلْمِ, every single person that's offended me, I forgive. إِلَّا مُبْتَدِعًا, except for the innovator. And he said, وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُ أَبَا إِسْحَاقْ يَعْنِي الْمُعْتَصِمْ. And he said, as for Mu'tasim, despite the fact that he imprisoned Imam Ahmed, rahimallahu ta'ala, was whipped due to his stance against Mu'tasim when it came to the creation of Quran. He was in prison. Imam Ahmed used to be beaten till he became unconscious. One time, Imam Ahmed, rahimallahu azza wa jal, he was beaten so bad he became unconscious. They split his body, they cut into his body, and he was unconscious, and they took a rotten piece of flesh and they stuck it inside him, and they sewn it up again. Imam Ahmed, rahimallahu azza wa jal, when he came around, he didn't know what the cause of the pain was, and it was explained to him. And in those days, there's no general or local anesthetic. They had to cut him open live and take that meat out. And as they were cutting him and taking it out, the same person that caused him to be imprisoned, whipped and tortured, Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah azza wa jal, was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. Subhanallah. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, those who pardon the people. And he used to say, recite the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلْيَعْفُ وَلْيَصْفَحُ, that pardon and overlook. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ, do you not love? أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. And the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sent this ayah down was concerning who? Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When Aisha radiallahu anha was accused by a man Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu used to do good for, of the ifk, the great lie against Aisha. Abu Bakr said, I'll never give him sadaqah again or forgive him. When Allah revealed this ayah, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he forgave him, overlooked, and whatever goodness he used to do for him before he said what he said, Abu Bakr increased it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those kadhimin al-ghayz, those who could control our temper, because that's the ultimate victory, to keep your temper. Because anger, it leads to a lot of bad consequences. Verbally, physically, that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تغضب, لا تغضب, لا تغضب, do not become angry. Do not become angry. Do not become angry. That we have to control, we have to try to control these temper issues. Many people have health issues. Last week we spoke about food and diet. One of the greatest causes of health issue is temper. Diabetes, high blood pressure, heart attack. All these things is what? Temper. Temper. And it's from shaitan. And that's why if you're angry, you should make what? Wudu. If you're standing, sit. If you're sitting, lie down. Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, to show how dangerous anger is, He mentioned the story of a person that became so angry that he wanted to speak and he held it in himself, but so was the anger, he died immediately. You're so angry sometimes, if you ever get to that, you just, that it could kill you. So anger, may Allah Ta'ala make us of those kadhimin al-ghayb, those who could hold themselves. Afina anil nas, those who pardon the people, so that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala may pardon us. And may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala make us of the muhsineen. Ameen. Inshallah, now I think it's questions.